welcome to Peace Easter Communion. Peace Communion of Faith is a progressive, multi-generational community called to transform the world by the power of God's love. My name is Gary Walpole, and I am pastor of Peace Communion of Faith. Since we are online, let me start by sharing a few thoughts on Easter, Resurrection, Communion, and then a few instructions to participate in Communion. Easter is a celebration of the power of life in the midst of death. Easter is a call to rise up. It is a call to stop finding ways to die and to start finding a way to live. I first heard these words spoken by a mother who had two sons who were in gangs. Unfortunately, the oldest son was killed in a gun battle, and at the funeral, his brother went up to the casket and laid his hand on it and said, "See you soon." His mother slapped the son and said to him, "Stop finding ways to die and start finding ways to live." It is a call for us to rise up with the power of life. Easter is a call for us to rise up. It is a call to take our hand off the casket and find a way to live. Easter is the power of life in the midst of death that cries out, "Rise up!" It is with the Spirit that we celebrate Easter Communion. At Peace, we practice open communion. We believe everyone who wishes to touch and taste life, who has a desire to be nurtured by the love of life. For people who desire to nurture others by the love of life, Christ welcomes them at the communion table. Easter is the call for us to rise up with the power of the God who is life, whose power for us is to share in the making of justice, the making of peace, and the birthing of love. Everyone who wants to rise up with the power to bring life in the midst of death is welcome at Christ's communion table. To participate, follow these simple instructions. Choose a comfortable place to sit and participate with a flat surface nearby. And on that flat surface, place a bite-sized piece of bread. It can be any type of bread you would like. And a small glass of juice, preferably grape juice, but if you don't have grape juice, any juice will do, or if you prefer, a small glass of wine. Then follow my lead when we come to the place during communion where we will eat the bread and when we will lift the cup. I will be dipping my bread into the cup. That is called intinction. If you prefer, you can take the bread and eat it, and then take the cup and drink it. There will be a music video during this time of sharing the bread and the juice or the wine. So take your time. Why don't you pause the video now to get everything ready? And then when you're back, we'll move on. Let's begin our time of communing together, remembering some important stuff. At the dawn of the universe, a spirit swirled into existence. rejoicing in the creative power to give life, to birth life. With intent, she moved throughout the universe, touching everything with the power to give life, to give birth. Even where it seemed there was only the death of nothingness, she gave the gift of life. And so, in the spinning of billions and billions of years, you and I were born into this wonderfully swirling thing of life we call Earth. Humanity was reminded again and again of the sacredness of this wondrous swirling ball of life by its spiritual leaders, the leaders of the Hindu faith, of the Jewish faith, of the Buddhist faith, of the Christian faith, of the Islamic faith, all reminding us of the sacredness of life, of the indigenous faiths reminding us, of all spiritual leaders reminding us of the sacredness of life. In this ceremony, where we claim the sacredness of the ordinary, we celebrate the gift of life. We are called to a feast of goodness. In a single piece of bread, in a small cup of juice, the whole universe swirls, and we call it sacred. In this bread of the earth and in this cup of the vine, we hear the echoes of creative power from the beginning. God looked at everything that she had made and found it very good. The goodness of this life-giving power was lived out in the person of Jesus. It was lived out in the healing of his life rather than in the destroying of life. It was lived out in the teachings that called us to nurture life rather than destroy life. It was lived out in ways that were selfless rather than self-centered or self-consuming. It was a call to rise up on behalf of life, a call that he was willing to give his life for. But even in the midst of death, life prevails. There are bonds of love, bonds that break the chains of death, that are active in the midst of death. In the midst of that death, there is love. In the midst of death, there is hope. In the midst of death, there is justice. In the midst of death, there is compassion. In the midst of death, there can be joy. In the midst of that death, there can be faith. In the midst of death, there is always, always life. Jesus understood this and was willing to give his life for it. We understand this too, and knowing it, we commit ourselves to the power of life, even in the midst of death. So, with a small piece of the bread of the earth and a small cup of the fruit of the vine, we feast on the universal gift of life that spins within us, around us, in our neighborhoods, among us, and upon the whole earth. And it is a power that spins us constantly into existence. We celebrate that in a small piece of bread and a small cup of the fruit of the vine. All life is connected, now and forever, with an invitation to rise up on life's behalf. We are welcome to this feast of victory and celebration. And so, Spirit of Life, let us see ourselves in the brokenness of the bread, which represents for us Jesus embodied in love, and in the sharing of the cup, which represents for us the life-giving essence of Jesus' love, so that we may realize that life has no bounds and can never be bound with the chains of death. Let us pray together. We offer ourselves to you, Spirit of Life, that we may see in the bread the sacredness of all life, and in this cup a feast of the power of life, even in the midst of death. Amen. The sharing of the bread of the earth and the fruit of the vine symbolize for us the body of Christ and the life of Christ, so that we may embody for the world the justice of Christ and the love of Christ. To participate in this communion is a call to engage our world through the power of God's life-giving love. I invite you to commune with me by eating the piece of bread and drinking from the cup of the juice or the wine. Take your time. When the music video "Rise Up, Lazarus" by Cain is finished, we will have a brief blessing to send us forth as a people who are loved and called to engage the world through the power of God's life-giving love. Please join me in communion.
Too scared to move and walk out of this tomb. Buried underneath the lies that you believed. Safe and sound, stuck in the ground, too lost to be found. You're just asleep, and it's time to leave. Come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, the power of death couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus?
Rise up, rise up,
oh,
rise up. resurrected hearts. Oh, he's calling us to walk out of the dark. He's giving us new resurrected hearts. Oh, come on and rise up, take a breath, you're alive now. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus? You're brand new, power that couldn't hold you. Can't you hear the voice of Jesus calling us out from the grave like Lazarus?
Life-giving Spirit, make us one with you, one with the Spirit of God's life-giving love in Christ, and one with each other, that we may join in the feast of life and offer to the world the feast of love. Amen.